What's going on? It's Eric Nathey with AboveTheBuzz.com. Today we are going to highlight four films that are due to be released in the month of August. First off, we have Rise of the Planet of the Apes. It's going to be released on August 5th. Second, we have 30 Minutes or Less, which is due to come out on August 12th. Now, as we move through the month, we hit Conan the Barbarian on August 19th. And last but not least, on August 26th is Our Idiot Brother. Rise of the Planet of the Apes is directed by Rupert Wyatt, and it stars James Franco and Frida Pinto. Now, this movie, if you want to take your kids to it, will be fine as long as they're over 13 due to the fact that it's rated PG-13. Now, Rise of the Planet of the Apes is a story of a scientist who creates this medicine that enables apes to be able to make cognitive decisions and be able to decide what's right and wrong and where they want to go. The problem with this medicine is that it creates an urge to escape captivity, and the apes then decide to try and take over the world. Now, about a month ago, I was watching the 2001 version of Planet of the Apes, which was directed by Tim Burton and starred Mark Wahlberg. And throughout the film, I was extremely entertained due to the overall concept of the story. However, I felt like it lacked in three different areas. One was the overall environment of the movie. Second was the image of the apes, the actual believability. And third was the depth in the story. Now, as I watched the trailer for Rise of the Planet of the Apes, I feel like all three of these areas of my concern have been addressed. First off, the environment. No longer are we on a faraway planet, but we're now located on our own world, building a connection with the location. Second off, advancements in technology have made it really believable that these are actual apes that live in cages. And third off is the depth of story. And I feel like this correlates with the environment quite a bit due to the fact that as an audience member, you are going to be able to connect with the characters and everything that's going on more if you know the location and the locale. Now, I'm going to be there on opening night to watch this movie. I'm going to give you a review and let you know if I feel that they met these three criteria and made the film a better success. But for now, check out the trailer and see what you think for yourself.
We're talking about huge potential for millions of people.
Our therapy enables the brain to repair itself.
We call it
the cure.
I want you to start testing on chimps ASAP.
We test one subject. I want to make sure it's stable.
I designed the 112 for repair, but Caesar's gone way beyond that.
You mean increased intelligence?
The skills that far exceed that of a human counterpart.
This is wrong, Will.
It works.
And what about Caesar? Where does he fit in?
That chimp's company property.
He hasn't spent any time with other chimps.
They're not people, you know.
You're trying to control things that are not meant to be controlled.
They are contaminated. Put those apes down.
You have no idea what you're dealing with.
Welcome back. I hope you enjoyed the trailer for Rise of the Planet of the Apes. And now we're going to move on to 30 Minutes or Less. Now, this movie is directed by Ruben Fleischer. It stars Jesse Eisenberg, Danny McBride, Nick Swartzen, and Michael Pena. As of now, the film's not yet rated, but I would expect that it would be rated R and at very least PG-13. The 30 minutes or less is the story of a pizza delivery boy who has a bomb strapped to his chest. Now, the bomb that was strapped to his chest by two criminals who insist that he robs a bank, otherwise they're going to blow him up. Now, when I watch this trailer, I see multiple things, but the first thing that comes to mind for me is Zombieland. Ruben Fleischer is the director of Zombieland, and when you watch the trailer, you see a lot of that movie in this film. And Zombieland, as you all know, was one of my top 10 picks of 2010. Now, also, this movie stars Jesse Eisenberg, and Jesse Eisenberg, also in Zombieland, did a great job, but The Social Network really brought him to a next level, and I think that he's going to be able to pull this role off perfectly. And also, Danny McBride, after I watched Your Highness, he really stood out to me because he has a great comedic talent. Now, a lot of movies, when the trailers are so good and really grab your attention, they tend to let you down when you get to the theaters because most of the funny parts were actually shown in the trailer and there's not much left. However, I do not feel that this film is going to be that way. But you go ahead and check out the trailer and see what you think.
The thing is, Kate makes some pretty questionable decisions, like moving to Atlanta.
Whatever, why are we talking about my sister?
I don't know.
You want to have sex with my sister, don't you?
Okay, your sister is attractive.
My twin sister? Which is basically like having sex with me?
Remember graduation night?
We were nailing Tina Scotto.
No, I was actually having the best night of my life with your sister.
What? You deflowered my sister? And I know all the details?
Hello.
Hello, pizza boy.
Oh, it's a great mask. Ah, another one. The missing link. That's very nice.
Get him!
Whoa.
No, dude, just take the pizza.
Oh, man. What do you want?
We got a duck.
We have nothing left to say to each other.
Two guys in masks jumped me and strapped a bomb to my chest, and now I have less than 9 hours to rob a bank.
You're hysterical. Great joke.
What the? Keep your voice down.
Is that thing real? And your first thought was to come to a school filled with young children?
It's a breeze.
Run into a bank with a bomb and take all the money and then leave and then go back to work.
Don't make a big deal out of it, all right?
Spinning the guns for the bank robbery. Cause if we go in with our plastic guns, then the cops will shoot us in our faces.
On to Conan the Barbarian. This movie is directed by Marcus Nispel, and it stars Jason Momoa and Rose McGowan. And this film is definitely rated R, not for the faint of heart. Now, Conan the Barbarian is a story of Conan as he travels across the world to dispel it of evil. And I must say from the very start that they could not have picked a better actor than Jason Momoa to play the role of Conan. Recently, I watched The Game of Thrones, which is a TV show on HBO, and he plays the role of the most fierce character I've ever seen in any show, any movie, named Khal Drogo. He is a barbarian leader that does unthinkable things. If Mr. Momoa can bring half of what he brings to that character into Conan, this role will be epic. At the same time, Marcus Nispel has had plenty of work dealing with gore and blood and things such as that in Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Pathfinder. Now, overall, I'm really looking forward to this film, not for its story structure or anything like that, but for its pure fierceness. And when you watch the trailer, you're going to see things that just blow your mind. But don't take my word for it. Go ahead and watch the trailer and see what you think.
I see a journey. A man
crossing the sands.
A knight.
A warrior. Your paths will merge.
Thank you. and despair. Your new master.
Kala raises the souls of the unspeakably evil.
You're sought to enslave all of Hyboria.
No man should live in chains. Run from me, and I will tear apart the mountains to find you. I will follow you to hell.
I hope that the Conan the Barbarian trailer really blew you away. But now we're going to move on to Our Idiot Brother, which was directed by Jesse Peretz, and it stars Paul Rudd, Elizabeth Banks, and Zooey Deschanel. Now, this movie is also rated R. And Our Idiot Brother is the story of an idiot brother who gets out of jail and must rely on his three sisters in order to help him get back on his feet. Now, when you first see the cast in this movie, you're going to automatically think that this is going to be a funny movie because they've all had experience in comedic timing and they've all released movies that have been funny to you and me. However, when you deal with a story such as this, when the character plays such a silly role, sometimes it just comes off way too silly and the connection's lost and it's not funny. But when I watched this trailer, I found myself becoming intrigued. I was paying close attention to what was happening, and I was really believing the overall message that the director was trying to present and the character was trying to play. Now, the reason that I think that that happened is because this role is made for Paul Rudd. When he can intrigue you by watching the trailer and you haven't even seen the movie yet, you know that the possibility for this movie is sky high. However, many times movies like this do fall to the comedic wasteland that is silliness. I don't know what's going to happen. I'm going to see the film and see which way it goes. For now, you check out the trailer and see what you think.
Ned, you always have the most gorgeous rhubarb.
It's Willie Nelson's poo that gives it that glow. My dog, Willie Nelson.
Oh, listen, you wouldn't happen to know where I can get some,
Even if I did, you really think I'd tell you?
It's been a hard week.
Yeah?
Yeah. Here you go, officer.
Hey, thanks, man.
Wow.
You're under arrest.
Oh.
Really?
I mean, Willie Nelson didn't do anything.
I'm your parole officer.
Why are you talking so slow?
I just figured that since you sold to a uniformed police officer, that you must be stupid.
Yeah. I get that a lot.
Ned just showed up.
I can't just kick him out. He's family.
Well, I gotta get back to work on the tumian.
What?
Tumian. It's a cross-pollination between a tomato and onion. Well, think of the time it'll save when you're making spaghetti sauce.
I love my brother, but let's
be honest,
he doesn't live in the adult world.
Check it out.
Tell me about Uncle Ned.
He just got out of jail.
In Japan for protesting about whales.
I thought you said he sold drugs to a policeman.
Oh.
I'm back living with my mom. Man, I screwed it up with my sisters.
Damn, Ned!
Our idiot brother just ruined my life.
What's wrong with you?
Now I try and do good, but it doesn't always work out.
I hope you enjoyed all the trailers today. And to recap, we covered Rise of the Planet of the Apes. we covered 30 Minutes or Less, Conan the Barbarian, and Our Idiot Brother. Now, tune in every Thursday to see what new movies are coming out those weekends, and I will go ahead and review these movies as they come out. And also, pay close attention to the end of August, because we're going to be coming out with another preview of September. Until then, this is Eric Nathey with AboveTheBuzz.com. Thanks for tuning in.